Hey, what's up, guys? How you doing? This is Mafia 2. I have played this game back in 2010. I think early 2010. And I finished the story and everything. And it was an amazing story. It was an amazing experience. It felt like playing a Godfather. Like Godfather and Goodfellas, all of these movies that we have seen in the past, it felt like that. And I enjoyed it thoroughly. This is a PC version. Everything is running on high 1080p, full screen, brightness, filtering of anisotropic filtering is high, it's 16 times, shadow quality is high, geometric details high, apex physics are high. Everything is to the highest level. So I just want to make sure that you guys know that I'm running this on the highest possible settings back then, you know. Because you have to remember, this game, it's like, 5 years old? So, but still looks good. Still looks great. All right. Hey, let me show you something really quick. I want to show you guys a benchmark. I just want to show you, like, how good looking this game still is on PC. Here, let me show you a couple of things. I'm going to show you a benchmark with the bullets and everything. Here, check this out. It's really cool. Considering this game, it's 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. This game, it's actually seven years old. So, still looks pretty fucking good. But here, check it out. Not bad, right? You see, I'm running it on a Titan X, so you guys can see that it is a Titan X. I got an AMD A8 processor. Pretty impressed for a game that's 7 years old, you know. It still looks freaking good. Yeah, even after 7 years, this game looks freaking great. But it's not the graphics. To me, it's mainly the storyline that I like about this game. That's the main purpose and the main reason why I played it was the storyline. That's why I'm excited about Mafia 3 coming out this October. And I'm definitely going to play it on PC version. There's no question about that. I mean, yeah, with Titan X, this game better run good, right? And I got a big ass cooling fan that I installed next to my Titan X. Hopefully you guys appreciate this. So yeah. Game still looks pretty good. Alright. Rank D, which is not bad. Obviously, the frame rate was 30 frames per second, but considering I got everything maxed out, 30 frames per second, it's still not that bad. All right, let's continue the story of VITO. VITO. Vito Carleone. I'm going to call him Vito Carleone. All right, so he's supposed to go up here and meet up with Joey, go to Joe's place. That's where he's supposed to go. And he's supposed to hook him up with some sort of a job, a score, work for this other guy. So.
Hey,
This guy just fell. You all right? You okay? All right, buddy. Get on your feet. But the detail is still there. You know what I mean? Like the bird, you can see the birds flying away. The game really looks lifelike, considering how old this game is. It still looks fantastic. As a matter of fact, it looks better than some of the new games that are out there, honestly. If you ask me. Well, let me cross the street. I know I'm jaywalking, but I don't care. Like, you can interact with people, you can hear them talking, like if like this example right here. This guy's fixing the car, the engine.
Is it fixed yet?
It's the same as when you asked me 10 seconds ago.
Crying out loud.
What the hell's the matter with you now?
It's taking you forever, and I'm cold.
Sit in the damn car if you're cold.
It's cold in the car, too. Hurry up and fix this piece of junk.
It'd get done a hell of a lot quicker if you quit nagging me and give me a hand.
Not nagging you.
Yeah, huh? Look, you're as good with a wrench as you go with your mouth.
I'm really curious how Mafia 3 is going to look. I mean, I'm still impressed by Mafia 2 and the detail they put into this game. Honestly, it's still freaking good. You really have that feel of 1940s, you know, and early 1950s. All right, so we're gonna head up to Joey's place. Look at all that detail, man, and shadows and everything. Looks amazing, right?
Thanks.
And the characters are always so different, like everyone's doing different things, you know.
Empire Times! Get your Empire Times here! Extra! Eastern seaboard buried under more heavy snow! Extra! Empire Bay Police Chief condemns black market gasoline stand! Right here! Extra!
Alright, so I'm gonna go up to the Joey's place. I think if I remember, when I first played the game, when you go up to meet him in the apartment, he's like surrounded by all these hookers and whatnot. And that's just Joey. He's a flamboyant dude. He's a playboy. Like these little details, like cigars being dropped down, you can see them and everything, you know. Now, obviously, you know, this is a PC version, so it looks this way. If you were playing like a PlayStation 2 version or Xbox version, it would have looked much different.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live.
Alright, he's right over here, on the right. That's where we're gonna meet his friend Joey. A playboy.
This is bad.
Nah, we ain't getting out at all. Come on in, let's talk. I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting.
crap.
All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. We have to stop and we can all have fun.
The fun's over, baby. Later, I say. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. Now, you know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
So Giuseppe is that guy he's gonna try to hook him up with. But Giuseppe, it's also very shady mobster. You know, he's making some shady deals and stuff. You know, he works for this other guy, this other mobster. And, well, you'll see. Let me adjust the brightness a bit. There we go. I think it's better like that. Yeah, it's much better.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me.
Yeah, I know you, Joey. Playboy. You can also use the phone, you know, I think I remember, you can also use the phone.
You got your own phone?
Yeah, and now you do too. Can't do business without it these days.
Now I'm going to go back to his garage.
So you thought about what you're going to do now?
You said you were going to introduce me to that guy Giuseppe.
No. I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was going to do when you got back?
No, not really. Well, besides the usual, you know. Find a nice girl, settle down.
Whoa. Hey, there's going to be plenty of time for that shit later. Right now, I'm going to make sure you live a little.
Hey, thanks again for that thing with the discharge papers.
Hey, all I did was make a phone call. You can thank Giuseppe when we go pick him up.
And he works for Giuseppe. That's the guy he's going to try to hook him up with. Sorry, Joey. Now he's going to bitch about his car. Because I want to drive it. Hey, I'm going to try to convince him to drive. To let me drive it.
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, never mind. You're gonna let me drive over?
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the...